after hundreds of prisoners were freed in raids linked to Al-Qaeda. Well, I'm joined now by terrorism analyst Robin Simcox, who's in our central London studio. Robin, thank you very much for your time this afternoon. It seems very much that this is the first alert of its kind since the death of bin Laden.
It is indeed, which I think goes to show how seriously not only the American government, but a range of governments, and including our own, are taking this threat. There seems to be very clear operational intelligence they've received regarding a potential attack, and the measures they've taken have been clear over the last couple of days to try and mitigate this.
And in all of it, it seems very much that Yemen is central. Certainly we as a country have also taken action to try and protect our embassy. Yemen seems to crop up time and again, particularly when we're talking about Al-Qaeda. What is the problem in Yemen?
Yemen has an extremely aggressive and determined Al-Qaeda affiliate based there, Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula. It's the group that attempted to blow up an aeroplane over Detroit back in Christmas Day 2009. It's placed cargo bombs in 2010 on planes there. It controlled territory in parts of Yemen until a government offensive expelled them. It's essentially Al-Qaeda's most ambitious, most aggressive, and most operationally capable branch in the world today. And so many of the plots we see emanating and attacking and potentially trying to attack Western targets are from this Al-Qaeda branch.
And in the last week, we've seen 5 drone attacks by the US on Yemen, and that follows a sort of quiet period, doesn't it?
Yes, the US has stepped up its campaign in Yemen recently. Yemen is an area that the US has launched several drone attacks over the past couple of years, and it's obviously a huge worry for them in terms of a source of terrorism. But there's been a lull somewhat recently. But the American government in the last week has really stepped up its campaigns in Yemen, which makes me think it's another piece of evidence to suggest that Yemen is the source of this latest threat, because they haven't disclosed exactly the nature of what it is they've discovered. The American government hasn't revealed what that is exactly, and it hasn't revealed exactly the source of the threat. But I think there's a number of indicators that lead me to believe that Yemen is the source of this latest threat.
And how unusual is it that this threat has sort of cropped up during Ramadan, which is traditionally a period of peace and goodwill gestures?
Well, I don't think Al-Qaeda really think in those terms, to be honest. Al-Qaeda will look to attack Western interests, Western targets, whenever they can. I think we can sometimes get too caught up in this idea that they will always look to coincide things with anniversaries. Al-Qaeda is an extremely determined organization that has a very clear intent to attack Western targets. The idea that they would do so or not do so depending on certain times of the calendar, I think is a false one. So this threat at the moment is very specifically based around this month, but it's not as if once this month is over, the threat will disappear. It's an ongoing one.
Okay, listen, thank you very much for your time. Robin Simcox, a research fellow for Henry Jackson, an analyst on terrorism and Al-Qaeda. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Now, more and more parents are turning to private tutors to help keep up their children's education.